I'm a plant pathologist, and resistance is our main form of control for a lot of diseases, and each year we publish our resistance ratings in a paper guide and in the Victorian Winter Crop Summary. We got sick of carrying around lots of books and stuff in the back of the car, and just seemed like a great idea to be able to look up the disease resistance ratings for crop varieties on your iPhone, you know, and so we took that to the next step and actually developed an app so we could do it. It has a lot of information about crops and has a lot of information about diseases. The main selling point is that it's got the resistant ratings for all the commonly grown crop varieties that we have in Victoria. It's also got images of the diseases that people would be looking at in the paddock, and you can also compare the disease resistance ratings for a number of different varieties. And if you're not sure what the disease is, you can take a photo with the iPhone or your iPad and you can mail it to your agronomist and let him identify it. These are our disease screening nurseries. We've got three bays of about 20,000 plants. We screen all these for rusts three times a year, and it's the rust resistance ratings that we get from these nurseries that go into the Crop Disease app. We had some really positive feedback and some quite interesting comments. One agronomist was telling me that farmers were actually sending photos of different amount of rust on the plants so we could give them a recommendation on maybe fungicide control based on the amount of rust on those plants. And we had another interesting bit of feedback. I did a talk for some Longrenong students, and apparently one of them used the app in an interview when she was asked, you know, how would she control this disease, and she just put out a phone and said she'd use the Crop Disease app, and apparently she got the job, so that was pretty good. It's pretty amazing, actually. I'm not a real IT type person, so it's been a big learning curve, and we've worked with the developers in Melbourne and have it actually up there in, you know, cyberspace or whatever it is. It's been fantastic, and the trick then is to keep it up there.